Choose young coconuts with a light white color shell. They are less oily than brown coconut. To open the coconut, hold it in the palm of your hand over a sink. Use a blunt edge of a heavy knife. Tap firmly in the middle of the coconut as you rotate it in the palm of your hand. Keep tapping and rotating until the coconut splits. Use a bowl to catch the juice. You can drink it or use it for your cooking. Break the coconut open into two halves, then whack each half with your knife to loosen the flesh a bit. It's okay if it's break into pieces while you do this. Then use a table knife or spoon to remove the flesh from the shell. Now use a potato peeler to peel off the husk. Then soak it in cold water. Wash each piece to remove any excess. Cut coconut lengthwise into thin slices. Ideally, the slice should be at least 2 inches long. Now, since I'm making two different colors and flavors, I'm dividing the coconut equally into two separate bowls. One will be for vanilla flavor and the other will be pandan leaf flavor. I also divide the sugar into two portions. One cup for the vanilla flavor bowl. Mix well. Cover and let the sugar soak into the coconut for about 2 hours or overnight. To make pandan leaf flavor coconut, wash the pandan leaf well, chop it up, then put in a food processor, add 1/3 cup boiling water, and grind it finely. Using a cheesecloth, hold the pandan leaf and squeeze as much of the extract as possible into the bowl. Continue squeezing until no more juice drips out from the cheesecloth, then discard the leaf. Mix well with the coconut. Next, add sugar. Mix well. You can use pandan leaf extract to make this easier, but I've compared the two and the fresh leaf extract tastes much better. The color is just perfect too. It doesn't look fake like the candy coconut you buy at the store. Then cover and let the sugar soak as with the vanilla coconut. Transfer the mixture into a pan, set over medium-high heat and bring to a boil. Add vanilla and mix well. Reduce the heat to medium at this point. Stir frequently while it's boiling. I use clear vanilla extract so that it doesn't add color to the coconut. When the sugar syrup is as thick as corn syrup, lower the heat further to slow the cooking and start stirring constantly to prevent the sugar from burning. Keep stirring until the sugar syrup looks dry and begins to recrystallize. It should take about 20 minutes. Finally, remove from the range and let it cool completely. Then store in an airtight container. To make the pandan leaf flavored coconut, use another clean pan and cook using the same method as with the vanilla coconut. Just be careful not to let the sugar burn. Aside from harming the taste, you won't get the beautiful green color if the sugar burns.